Let us find the magnitude direction of resultant of two forces, 3 newton and 4 newton, acting at an angle of 90 degrees. Now for this purpose, we have the formula. Resultant of two forces, P and Q, is given by R square equal to P square plus Q square plus 2pq cos theta. Here p equal to 3 newton, q equal to 4 newton, and angle theta equal to 90 degrees. And so r square equal to 3 square plus 4 square plus 2 into 3 into 4 into cos 90 degrees. Cos 90 degrees is 0. So this is equal to 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, that's equal to 25. Taking square root both sides, we have r equal to 5. We ignore negative sign because we want the magnitude of resultant, and magnitude must be positive. So magnitude of resultant is 5 units. What about direction? For that purpose, we have the formula tan alpha equal to q sin theta divided by p plus q cos theta. Here theta equal to angle between p and q is given by 90 degrees. So this is equal to q sin 90 degrees, we know the q equal, here we have p equal to 3 newton, q equal to 4 newton. So instead of q, let's write 4 newton, call this 4. Sin 90 degree, divided by p is 3 newton, so 3 plus 4 cos 90 degrees. We know sin 90 degrees equal to 1. And we also know that cos 90 degrees equal to 0. So this is 3 plus 0. We have started with tan alpha equal to this. And so we have, once again, tan alpha equal to 4 by 3. And so alpha equal to tan inverse 4 by 3. Now, that's the end of your first question. When angle equal to angle between those two forces thing, 90 degree, we have got resultant equal to 5 unit in magnitude, and its angle is 10 inverse minus 4 by 3. Let's compute same thing for the second case, when let's compute the resultant and theta equal to 120 degree. Once again, r square equal to p square plus q square plus 2pq cos theta. Here p equal to 3, so this is 3 square, q equal to 4, so this is 4 square plus 2 into 3 into 4 is 12 into cos 120 degrees. That is 9 plus 16 plus 24 into cos 120 degrees. That is cos minus of cos 60 degree, cos 60 degrees 1 by 2. 9 plus 16 minus 12. That is 13. So we take square root to get r equal to square root 13. Now what about the angle? Once again, tan alpha equal to, we have the formula. What is the formula we have? We have tan alpha equal to q sine theta divided by p plus q cos theta. Q sine theta divided by p plus q cos theta. Well, theta is 120 degrees, so this is the value of q here. P is 3, q is 4. 4 sine 120 degree divided by 3 plus 4 cos 120 degree. Sine 120 degree is same as sine 60 degree, and sine 60 degree is root 3 by 2. Cos 120 degree is same as minus of cos 60 degree, and cos 60 degree is 1 by 2, so cos 120 degree is minus 1 by 2. 4 into, we can cancel it, we'll get 2. 2 into 2 is 4. And 3 minus 2 is 1, so this is equal to 2 root 3. Therefore, alpha equal to tan inverse 2 root 3. So we have determined the magnitude. In this case, magnitude of resultant is root 13. Magnitude of resultant is root 13. And the angle is tan inverse 2 root 3, but that has to be with respect to